America should have an opportunity to grow up healthy. I think we can do it if we have people in Congress that are willing to work and take the tough votes and get the job done.
The issue of health care is important for all Americans, not only for their personal lives, but for our success and future of the country. Each year, health care costs have continued to escalate, and without steps taken to control those increases in costs, we really risk losing a lot of our economic advantage and the jobs that go with it because of an uncontrolled increase in health care costs. The federal government's role should be twofold. To help reduce costs, we have to look at lower cost alternatives to our current system. One study recently estimated that 25% of all health care dollars in the United States go just to pay for paperwork. Now, some paperwork is necessary for health care, but not 25% worth. And I think we have to go back and look and see what is necessary and what can be consolidated to help reduce that component of the cost. Second, I used to work at the Visiting Nurse Association of Boston as a service coordinator. And I learned there that home care is not only often better for a patient, but usually, almost always, it's less expensive than a hospital stay as well. So as much as possible, we should be promoting lower cost alternatives like home health care to hospital stays as a way of reducing costs. To help make health care more accessible to all Americans, I favor a system of tax credits which could only be used to purchase health insurance and which would apply to everyone, whether they were employed or not. This will allow the quality of care in America to continue making health care more accessible. I oppose the proposals to have a single payer, or what's called the payer-pay plan. A single payer similar to Canada would eliminate the quality we have in our system. If you're in Canada, you have to wait 42 weeks for heart bypass surgery, something I think no American wants to do. The payer-pay system only puts the problem on small business and doesn't offer any solution. It would result in fewer Americans working as well. So I support a system of tax credits to help make healthcare more accessible and cost reductions to help make it more affordable.
One of the most important things I've learned over the last year in my travels and running my business is how important healthcare is, not only to myself and my family, but to people all over this country. I traveled to Eastern Europe several times, to Czechoslovakia, Hungary, Slovenia. Over there, centralized bureaucracies haven't worked. And one thing is clear to me, that setting up a centralized bureaucracy is not the answer to our healthcare system. We have to provide choice for all of the people in this country, and we have to begin to manage care in a much more cost-effective way. I would support having tax credits and tax incentives to individuals that invest in healthcare. We need to make sure that small businesses, such as the one that I ran, can participate in HMOs and PPOs, beginning to give those people the opportunity not only to do that at a small level, but individuals who invest in healthcare to be able to use their investment in healthcare insurance as a tax deduction. We need to address that, but then there are going to be some that don't have an opportunity for healthcare. The Kennedy-Mitchell plan talks about a monolithic plan that would apply to all of us, but we'd exclude the congressmen and the senators and the 11 million people on the federal plan. I think that's the answer why that won't work. What I would agree on, however, and I think is a good plan, is to develop a medical voucher system for those who don't have access to medical care and allow them to use those vouchers in the federal system, the one that's good for the congressmen and the senators and the 11 million federal employees. I would support that. One thing that we have to do as a country is address the medical care needs. One of the areas that I think would help in this thing would be through the training schools, to provide more training and incentives for medical general practitioners rather than specialists. By getting more general practitioners, we'll have more people in getting medical health care.
The two issues in health care are access and escalating costs. And most of my opponent's plans addresses one of those, but not the other. I have a plan that's quite unique that addresses both of those. One, we have 40 million Americans who are not part of the health care process. Of those, there are 10 million children, and that's scandalous. That means when a young child has an ear infection, instead of easily going to a doctor and getting an antibiotic, that child cries for days and perhaps will be beaten, perhaps will go deaf, perhaps will lose a lot of productivity in life. We cannot afford that, so we have to guarantee access. The other is we have the most expensive health care system in the world, one-third more expensive than Canada, the next highest. I have a voucher plan. A voucher plan means that every American will receive health vouchers that they can apply to their health care and that they can use strategically. I encourage the creation of community clinics where those vouchers will go the furthest. Or if you choose to get a CAT scan at Mass General, that's your choice. I also believe that part of the problem is there are a lot of greedy players in the healthcare industry that are just fighting each other to how to cut up all that money. We need to create something resembling the Federal Reserve Bank. The Fed fairly regulates our economy by being above the fray. We need to create a Fed to regulate the healthcare industry. This Fed could set the rate at which these healthcare vouchers could be redeemed. They could set the rate at which doctors are compensated. This is a dramatic way to change the current environment without risking destroying the system. It may be a transitional phase. We may decide to go further in several directions, but this is a reasonable, intelligent way to not break the bank and not keep the child out of the healthcare system. I think you will agree. We need to be careful not to destroy what we have, but we need to change dramatically.
Let me close out this final minute by talking to our people here in the Beverly and other parts of the district that will be watching this program. I think that I've given you a dedicated and devoted service over the last 14 years, and hopefully I come back to you requesting your vote on September 15th for the record of achievement. I have been very proud of my record. Whether or not I am answering the telephone or my staff will take care of a veteran who cannot get his or her check at the end of the month with Social Security problems for the elderly, I've taken national, international issues on, as I did many years ago when we killed the MX missile and we saved the country $18 billion. That is a great deal of pride for me. Or when I was able to get through the hearing impaired bill, whereby 5 million Americans will be helped who have an impairment of the hearing. I think I've produced and I've done a good job. I'm asking for your support on September 15th to continue this good work.
This year we face a chance to really change America, and that's why I decided to run for Congress this year. We're at a crossroads where we may elect 100, 150 or more new members of Congress, and this is going to be our opportunity to make those changes. Since April, when I left my position in the Wells Administration, I've been campaigning on issues of change, the need to bring jobs back to our district by rebuilding our economy, through an investment tax credit, through a reduction in the capital gains tax, and other incentives to help encourage jobs, through fundamental changes in Congress, including term limitations, reduction in the number of subcommittees, and eliminating the special exemptions that Congress enjoys for itself, including exemptions from the Social Security Act and even the Equal Pay Act. But to make these changes, I need your support. On September 15th in the Republican primary, I would appreciate your vote for Peter Torkelson, Republican candidate for the United States Congress. With your help, we can make these common sense changes in Washington. Thank you.
Our country is facing the greatest challenge we've ever faced. And I believe we live in the greatest country on this earth. And I believe we can meet those challenges. We have to do something about the $4 trillion national debt and the fact that as a country we're spending $1 billion a day more than we bring in. We have to do something about education reform, welfare reform, healthcare reform. And the way to begin to do that is by restructuring and changing Congress. I'm a small businessman. I know what it means to meet a payroll. I know what it means to create jobs. I'm the only person running in this race to replace that experience in the private sector. I also have worked in the political arena and helped rebuild the Massachusetts Republican Party. I believe I've proven that I have the effectiveness to go to Washington and bring the energy and the vitality to fight the Washington bureaucracy and to change the direction of this country. With your support and with your help, I know I can, and we'll work together to change the direction of this country. Thank you.
For the past 9 years, I've been serving the people of Amesbury, Newburyport, and Salisbury as their representative in the state legislature. They have returned me 4 times because they know that I'm a person of integrity who has worked hard for their needs. I've been recognized for my outstanding work as a legislator in the areas of human services, the environment, and education reform. I was named Legislator of the Year by the Child Advocacy Network for my work on behalf of children, and Legislator of the Year for my work on behalf of the elderly. Now I want to go to Congress to make a difference, because we can't afford business as usual any longer in Washington. We have to have people that we know we can put our trust in. We're going to work hard to revive our economy, to get health care for our citizens, education for our children, and I know we can do better. We must do better, and I ask you for your support. Thank you.
An 80-year-old man told me recently he lived through the Great Depression, but he's much more concerned now. And I said, why is that? He said, then only the economy failed. We had strong families. We had strong extended families. We had communities. We had neighborhoods. We had churches. Now we have none of those. When the economy continues to fail now, it's going to rip through our society. The last force that will hold it together is the American family, and a major part of my candidacy is based on strengthening the family, keeping the pressure in our society from building on that family. I'm for strong daycare, strong health care, and parental leave. But more important is I can recession-proof this district like nobody else so that the family doesn't have to go through the kind of economic pressures that it will go through. It's going to get worse before it gets better, and we better pick someone who can change about that. I'm the only one, not part of the system, who can change the system as it is now.
At this time, I want to take the opportunity to thank our community for participating in the Women's Voters Guide, as well as Continental Cable Vision for their technical support and guidance. And also to remind you, the voter, to make your informed choice and vote on primary election day, September 15th. Thank you.